Many times with our dairy cattle, we have to provide them with medicine, and some of the medicine comes in the form of a bolus. We have three different types of pills or boluses that we could administer to our cattle. The pink bolus here is basically a magnesium product to help control acidosis or rumen acidosis. It also works as a laxative. Our middle bolus here is a gel cap contained with a yeast product that can be used to stimulate rumen appetite and rumen motility. And our final bolus here is a magnet that we can use to give to our cattle. Because our cattle are indiscriminate eaters, they will actually consume many foreign objects during their time of eating and swallow them down into their rumen. Many of those foreign objects can be quite sharp and can cause damage, leading to specific diseases, one specifically known as hardware disease. So that's why we may administer a magnet to try to secure those sharp objects within her reticulum or rumen so they don't penetrate through and cause problems. Today I'm going to demonstrate giving a rumen yeast cap to this cow. And the way that we give a rumen yeast cap is we actually use a balling gun. This is a multi-dose balling gun or pilling gun. So we have an entire chamber that can be filled with many different types of boluses. The way it works is we pull the plunger back and we insert the boluses into the chamber. And then if we're only going to give one bolus, we can actually bring our plunger all the way flush up against the bolus. Once we place this bolus into the cow's mouth, we want to make sure that this chamber goes back far enough so that this bolus will actually be dropped into the pharyngeal area of the cow. In order for that to happen, this point of the balling gun must be directly flush up against the commissure of her mouth. And that will allow enough length for the pills or the boluses to actually be dropped into the pharyngeal area behind the big bump in the back part of our cow's tongue. So again, we're going to secure the cow's head in order to place this balling gun. Again, I prefer to be very balanced, use my legs for leverage, and then once I have a hold of the animal's head, in order to open her mouth to place the gun, I actually need to insert my left hand into her mouth under her lip on the left side. So I will take my hand and place it under her lip right here on this side. And then what I will do is actually rub the roof of her mouth so she opens her mouth for me, place the balling gun into her mouth, slide it down along the side of her teeth all the way as far back as I can, then place my thumb on the plunger and actually dispense the balling gun, the magnet into the gun. Into the pharyngeal area. Once we're done with that, we come out. We lift her head up so that she actually will swallow the medicine down. That's boluses. Sometimes we're required to give gels or paste for certain diseases. What we do here is we use this device here, which is a basic caulking gun. And then we attach the chamber onto the caulking gun. We set it in place to work. And again, we'll rub the roof of her mouth, opening her mouth, insert the tube into her mouth. And then once we're as far back as we can, we start clicking the handle, which will actually click the plunger down through the tube, dispensing the gel or paste down into her pharyngeal area where she will swallow. Mostly the doses, the entire tube is dispensed into an adult dairy cow. And usually the product that we typically use is calcium or any sort of calcium or mineral product to provide calcium levels for this animal to absorb. Sometimes we need to administer very small volumes of fluids, like 16 ounces of a certain compound that can help to control ketosis in our cattle. This is a 16-ounce container that we use. We attach a rubber tubing, onto the top of the container, and then the same procedure is in place. We secure the animal's head, we lift her lip, rub the roof of her mouth, insert the tube into her mouth, and just hold it up as high as we can while she chews on the tube. It's a disposable tube. She won't necessarily damage it. We can dispose it when we're finished, and we just allow the entire contents of the container to dispense into her pharyngeal airway. She will swallow it down into her rumen. Once they're done treating, they usually have a very characteristic Fleming response. It gives you a good indication that she's swallowed the products down and they're in her rumen.